So how did the NOS develop? Well, until 1983, network operating systems were used mostly on mainframe computers, allowing terminals to access files from the mainframe. The terminals were just used for displaying the information, so all the computing power resided in the mainframe. This, coupled with the slow-speed links to the mainframe, made network computing slow. As PCs became more popular, though, people wanted an easy way to network them. A company called Novell came out with its NOS product called NetWare, which was used to network PCs. NetWare received widespread acceptance because it was affordable and because organizations recognized the power of personal computers to make day-to-day business easier and faster. Businesses realized that it was more productive to place powerful computing applications, like word processing and spreadsheets, on the employees' computers rather than running them centrally on slower mainframe computers, or still slower, manual typewriters. NetWare allowed files to be stored in one location and accessed by multiple users. It also allowed organizations to get the most of their investments in expensive resources like printers, hard drives, and so on, by allowing multiple people to share them. Novell's NetWare dominated the NOS market, capturing 80% of the worldwide NOS market share by 1994. However, in 1992, Microsoft introduced a new, radically different OS called NT, which stands for New Technology. Because Microsoft at that time was beginning to dominate the PC market, people thought it was logical to get their NOS from Microsoft as well. Microsoft also bundled applications within the NT NOS, and this made NT even more attractive. Another reason NT caught on is that it had a graphical interface for network administrators, which made it simpler and easier to configure than NetWare. Finally, NT was less expensive, and this final reason made it the NOS of choice for many schools and companies. By the end of 1998, the two dominating NOSs were Novell NetWare and Microsoft NT.